Hey family, it's your sister Andrionna-Janay and I am back with another word. I'm so sorry y'all, I could not get on live tonight for Bible study, so the Holy Spirit just has me bringing this word to you guys. So I pray that it blesses every single person that it's intended for. Please test the Spirit, take it back to the Lord, and allow Him to confirm and unfold this to you. But I pray that your hearts are open to receive this word, because it is going to probably ruffle the feathers of some of his daughters, because Holy Spirit is saying a lot of his daughters are battling with pride right now, and he is wanting to purge his daughters of this spirit of pride, because he cannot have you going into this marriage still prideful. He cannot have you going into this marriage still with a conditional love type of mentality and type of heart posture. So he's wanting to strip you of that. Hence is why he's giving you certain instructions that he's giving you. Not for the fact of one being right and the other one being wrong, but he really wanting to strip his daughters of pride and ego and really cultivate you into being and embodying what a true wife, a kingdom wife is, and how a kingdom wife operates and is presented to her husband. So yes, let's get started. Again, God is calling a lot. Okay, so a lot of his daughters have been under this impression that, you know, the kingdom spouse is going to reach out. This is in regards to prodigal spouses, should I say. This word is specific for prodigal spouses. Those are you who are standing in agreement with the Lord's promise that your prodigal spouse will return back to you. This is who this word is for. And a lot of you are under this impression that, you know, they're going to come reaching out to you. They're gonna come texting and calling and you know, pouring their hearts out to you, which may be the case for some, which is the case for some. But then there's the other half who this word is for, who that's not the case, who God may instruct you to reach out to this person, who God may instruct you to call or give them a text or check on them. That's who this word is for. The Lord has given you an instruction to reach out to your prodigal spouse, and you have had a hard time doing it because you believe that they should be chasing after you. Either you believe, based on how it ended, they should be the ones reaching out to you, or just for the simple fact that he's the man and you're the woman, and you believe that, you know, the man should be chasing you in pursuing you, is why you have a heart posture of not really wanting to take heed to what the Holy Spirit is instructing you to do. And the Lord doesn't want you operating in disobedience. He does not want you operating in disobedience. The Lord is saying to his daughters, you can choose to be disobedient, but that's not going to move me. You will stay in this place as long as you're disobedient. My instruction is my instruction. Whatever I told you to do, that's just what I told you to do. There's no way around it. There's no over it, underneath it, around it. There's nothing. When I give you an instruction, that's what it is. So you can choose not to do it, and you can stay in this place, or you can strip yourself and allow me to strip you of the pride and ego so you can go forth with what I'm giving you to do. Because however way you flip it, it's like you're going to do what I tell you to do. Jonah, come on, Jonah. At the end of the day, you're going to come back in position and do what I told you to do. I don't care what you think they should. I don't care how much you believe that they owe you a phone call or they owe you a text. What I told you to do is what I told you to do. Lean not on your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge me. You acknowledge me by your obedience. Come on. You acknowledge me, Holy Spirit, the Lord, your Father, by your obedience. Come on. God is saying he is stripping his daughters of pride. He's stripping his daughters of pride. Y'all, I have my notes here. He's stripping his daughters of pride. So, Holy Spirit wanted me to share with y'all the dream that I had, which just like confirmed. So, in the dream, there was a my prodigal spouse, right? So in the dream, there was my prodigal spouse, right? And oh shit, thank you, Lord, for your revelation. And he was at the airport and he was rushing, right? And he was rushing and to get wherever he was needing to go. And he needed, he couldn't, he was rushing so much that he couldn't get his bags from baggage claim. So I remember my cousin. She calls me and she says, hey, so-and-so needs you to get his bags. And I remember in it, I was like kind of prideful, like, why I got to get his bags? Why he can't, like, you know, get his own bags, like whatever the case may be. And the Holy Spirit just revealed to me, because my cousin, her name means gift, a gift, gift of God. And the Holy Spirit was saying, Andrionna, that was the Holy, that was my spirit saying, right? I need you to go assist your kingdom spouse in a way that you think that they should be doing it. Like, oh Jesus, what should be their responsibility to do? I need you to humble yourself and go do it. Like most of you. Like, no. The way it ended, the way they left me, the way that they, like, refused to talk to me, they need to be the one reaching out to me, right? That's the heart posture I had in the dream. Like, why do I need to go get his bags? He can get his own bags. Come on. Holy Spirit is saying, you don't understand what I'm doing behind the scenes. You don't understand. You're so busy. One, you're so busy focused on your pride and what you think they should be doing. You're so focused on them and what you think they should be doing and not enough. And you're not in enough of full submission of what I'm doing. You're so focused on them that you're not in full submission on what I'm doing, because I do behind the scenes work. You're too busy looking at in front of the scenes, what you see in the physical, but I'm doing behind the scenes work that you don't even see. And you don't even know that your obedience is a planting a seed that is going to manifest in the very thing that you desire, but you're not getting that manifestation because you're not planting the seed. Come on. Come. Ooh. My God, Holy Spirit is talking. Holy Spirit is talking. Holy Spirit is talking. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. You're so focused on the manifestation and you're not understanding your obedience is planting the seed to get that very manifestation. But it takes you being humble. It takes you being humble. It takes you being prideless. It takes you stripping yourself of ego. Allowing the Holy Spirit to strip of pride and ego. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. God is calling you to posture yourself as an unconditional servant. Come on, come on. You are to serve your husband. You are to serve him unconditionally. Reverence him unconditionally as you do Christ. Because your husband is Christ in your household. Come on, Ephesians 5. Come on. You are to be unconditional. God is teaching his daughters, come on, how to take an humble role. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Yeah. Holy Spirit, go back to that. Being obedient no matter of the outcome. No matter of the outcome. You're like, well, I did this and their reaction was this. God said, don't fix your focus on that. Take your eyes off of the reaction and submit to the instruction. Take your eyes completely off of what the reaction will be and focus yourself on the instruction. Remain obedient in the instruction. God is calling you to be so unconditional that when he tells you to do something, it's unto the Lord. Everything you do is unto the Lord. It's not unto your husband. It's not unto man. Everything that you do is unto the Lord. So you being obedient is unto the Lord. It's not for it. I mean, it's for your spouse, but you're being obedient unto the Lord because you're in full submission and reverence to the Lord. Come on, man. Come on, Jesus. Come on. Come on. Come on. You're talking, Lord. Yeah. Talk that talk. Come on. Yeah. He's like, say it. Talk that talk. Yeah. Come on, Holy Spirit. Yeah. Your obedience is unto the Lord. You don't know what he's doing. Your obedience is sowing seed. It's planting seed and you don't even realize it because you're so caught up of what the reaction is. You gotta let that go. You gotta say, unto you, Lord, I do it unto you. I'm gonna be obedient, and I take my hand off the whatever comes of it, comes of it. But I know I was obedient. I know what I did what you told me to do. You handle the rest. I give that back to you. You do it as you please. And yeah, and that's not an easy thing to do, but it's a choice. It's a choice. It's a choice. It's a choice. This is all choices. It's a choice. It's a choice. And it's really sitting with yourself and saying, I can either do it the Lord's way or I can do it my way. And we know where our way gets us. So no matter what it is, Lord, I choose it. Yes, Lord. Yes to your will. Yes to your way. Come on. He's calling us to be unconditional a servant in love in these marriages. Unconditional. Come on, 1 Corinthians. Come on, 1 Corinthians 13. Come on. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not boastful. Love is not proud. Love does not hold any record of wrong. Love does not hold any record of wrong. Somebody needs to hear that. Love does not hold any record of wrong. Anything that happened yesterday and prior does not matter anymore. Love does not hold any record of wrong. Come on. God is calling you to be unconditional in the way that you're loving his sons. And it starts even now in just the instruction that he is giving you. Are you willing to be humble and a servant to the Lord and unto your husband by being obedient to what the Lord is telling you to do? Despite if they're deemed worthy or deserving of the instruction that God is giving you, of the action God is telling you to take. Come on. Come on. Humble servants. Humble servants. God says, stop looking to be chased and learn how to serve. Stop looking to be chased and learn how to serve. Come on. Water a plant and watch it grow. You will get the very manifestation that you're looking for if you water that plant. If you sow that seed. Come on. Come on. The manifestation of what you want depends on you sowing seed. You sowing seed. You sowing seed into that man. You sowing seed. And I'm telling you, you're going to reap the harvest of the very thing that you desire. Yes, they will pursue you. But not until God can fully strip you of pride. Not until he can fully purge you and cleanse you of pride. Come on, God. Oh, shit. Stripping you of that mentality. I'll only do this if he did this. Or I'm not doing this because he did this. Stripping you of that conditional love. Stripping you of that transactional love. Stripping you that even if they don't deserve it, I'm doing it. Come on. Even if they don't have it to give it back to me, I'm going to do it. Come on. Because my cup is never empty. My cup is forever running over because the Lord fills me up. The Lord fills me up. So whatever I don't receive from my husband, I get from the Lord. Come on. And that's not to say you won't get it, but water a plant and watch it grow. Plant the seed. Sow the seed. Come on. Come on. We're almost done. We're almost done. We're almost done. The last point was the Lord saying that he knows how far he can push his sons and at what pace. But it's kind of like putting pieces in its proper place. God is like, okay, I got him here. So if you do this, this will bring him here. And then if you do this, he'll come here. And him coming here will bring you here. And then it kind of like Tetris. Like if you put here, you don't understand. You being obedient is getting him into the place and into alignment that God is calling him to be for the manifestation that you want. But you're so focused on being prideful and wanting it your way that you're not understanding the behind the scenes work that the Holy Spirit is doing for you. Come on. Come on. God knows what his son needs to get the full manifestation of who he is calling him to be. So God knows if he needs you to reach out to him this one time, the seed that's going to plant in him to be able to be more comfortable. Oh, shit. Speak, Holy Spirit, to be more comfortable. To be more comfortable and more confident and bold in coming back to you and pursuing you in the way that the Lord is intended. He's going to pursue you, but not until the Lord strips you. Not until he purges you. Not until he fully cleanses you of that ego, of that pride. Come on. Come on. What the Lord is calling you to do is going to break barriers that you can't even see. You can't see. It's going to break barriers that you cannot see. Be obedient. You don't know the work that's being done behind the scenes because of your obedience. But you're missing it because of your pride, and you're missing it because when the Lord gives you an instruction, you're expecting. He didn't tell you what the reaction was going to be. He didn't tell you what the response is going to be. You created it in your head and you assumed that, okay, if he told me this, I'm going to receive this. Stop worrying yourself about the reaction. Just be obedient. Unto the Lord. Whatever comes of it, I know I was obedient. Unto the Lord. Y'all, I pray this blessed you. Whew, that's the word. I love y'all. I love y'all so much. Holy Spirit, I just thank you, Lord God. I just pray that you cover over every ear under the sound of my voice. Every single daughter that this word is intended for, use it to ignite change within them. Use it to spark, Lord God, a cleansing and a purging, Lord God, of them right now, Lord God, so they can walk into and they can participate in the manifestation of your promise for them. It's participation, Lord God, that you're looking for. It's participation that you're after, Lord God. A humbled servant to participate in the manifestation, Lord God, of your promise. We thank you. We honor you. We love you. It's in your precious name we pray. Amen. All right, y'all. If you would like to sow, you can do so at the Cash App on the screen. If you would like to send in your prayer request, you can do so with the email on the screen. And if you would like to book your one-on-one coaching session, you can do that with the link in the description box. I love y'all so much. I pray this blessed you tremendously. And I will see you in the next video as the Holy Spirit leads. Good night.